Yunkunda Traore, former president of Mali and chairman of IAPP, the International Association of Parliamentarians for Peace, on the stage. Please welcome former president Yunkunda Traore. Monsieur le président, s'il vous plaît. Your translation devices.
Distingués délégués, invités et participants à ce sommet africain, conférence des leaders, j'ai le redoutable privilège, tant la personne que je vais vous présenter a une vie riche et profonde. Mais je vais essayer, en quelques mots, de vous parler de cette personne exceptionnelle qui a pour mission de conduire notre fédération. Je vais donc essayer de dire quelques mots d'introduction à notre hôte pour cet important rassemblement. Personne d'autre que le docteur Agja Anmoun, connu par beaucoup d'entre nous par sa tendresse et respectueusement connu comme Mère Moon ou Vraie Mère, la fille unique de Dieu. Elle dirige maintenant un mouvement mondial qui s'étend sur le globe, atteignant chaque coin, est, ouest, nord, sud. Elle gère un vaste réseau de programmes, d'organisations et d'initiatives qui se rapportent au gouvernement, à la religion, aux médias,
aux
milieux universitaires, aux arts, au sport et à la société civile. Bref, tout ce qui compte pour notre vie sur cette terre.
Everything that we need for this,
la Fédération pour la paix universelle
est à l'avant-garde de ce mouvement
en tant que réseau mondial.
Very top and working really hard to make this happen. And peace ambassadors from all over the world, peace ambassadors from all walks of life. And there's only been 7 years since her husband, her husband, Dr. Sun Myung-moon, passed away and put her at the head of this movement, which she's kept taking care of, and with a lot of wisdom and with a lot of determination. It is very difficult to imagine that she is Korean. Even though we know that Korea had been during this time, she really worked very hard, and Korea had really been she lived under brutal occupation by the Japanese during the early 20th century, and that left many scars on Korea. She endured the defeat, the World War II, which led to the liberation and the establishment of national sovereignty in 1948. However, it was not long before the Korean War broke out at the and she escaped from the North Korea to the South. But as she says often, God protected her, knowing that she had a spiritual mission. She met Father Moon in the 1950s, and they got married in 1960, marking a major turning point in her ministry. They worked side by side for 52 years as the true parents. And since Father Moon passed, she has been a greatest champion and indeed a heavenly and only begotten daughter of true love and peace. She stands before us today to provide a profound spiritual message. And I really ask you to please give your full and respectful attention. And I want to give a warm welcome to the Universal Peace Federation Foundation and co-founder, the true mother, the universal mother, the heavenly begotten daughter of God, Dr. Hak Chahan Moon.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. Now let us prepare ourselves. The founder of UPF will enter.
La fondatrice de l'UPF va maintenant nous joindre.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us all rise and give a warm welcome to the founder of UPF, True Mother, Dr. Hak Chahan Moon. True Mother is coming. A warm welcome to True Mother. You will need your translation device because Mother will speak in Korean. Please use your device. Please be seated.
Africa Summit에 참석하신 각계 지도자, 신사 숙녀 여러분, 우리는 하나님을 믿습니다.
We believe in God, and in particular, God loves Africa. Jesus Christ mentioned, love your neighbor as yourself. However, when we look back at the 6,000-year history of humanity, we can see that this history has been filled with war, conflict, division, and the confusion that has ensued from all of these conflicts has brought tremendous pain. And following Jesus Christ's crucifixion, Jesus asked the Christian followers, love others, practice love. And all nations who embraced Christianity strove to practice love, but they did not fully understand the meaning, the value and importance of practicing true love. And today, when we look at the world, even nations that are Christian, they are afflicted by war, conflict, division. And when we look at the problems afflicting today's world, leaders of the world wonder, what shall we do to solve the problems afflicting society? That is why today I wish to speak to you about the Creator God, I believe that the solution to humanity's problems lies in truly understanding God. Christians speak about Jesus, but how many fully understand His essence? Originally, God created Adam and Eve, and God created heaven and earth according to His image. God created the mineral world. God created the plant and animal kingdoms. God created everything in pairs, male and female. Plus and minus, He created everything. And lastly, God created a man and a woman to become the first human ancestors. And to the first human ancestors, God gave a responsibility, which was to go through a period of growth through which they could learn about God and practice His will. The dream that God harbored was for human beings to become fruitful, resemble Him, so that the invisible God, through His beloved children, could become the true parents of all humanity. However, due to the fall of Adam and Eve, due to their excessive greed, due to their fall, God's original ideal was frustrated. When we look at the history of the fall, the fall brought tremendous pain to heavenly parent, but also to humanity. The purpose of God's creation was to be eternal. God created the universe for eternity. And because God is love, God had no choice but to engage the painful history of the providence of restoration through indemnity to save fallen human beings. And this history of restoration through indemnity was so difficult and painful that it took 4,000 years for God to raise the chosen people of Israel and finally send His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. It took 4,000 years for God to send Christ. Therefore, Mary, who gave birth to Jesus, the Jewish leaders of the time, the people of Israel at the time, their responsibility was to understand who Jesus truly was, the purpose of His advent, and the mission He came to fulfill. Unfortunately, even before Jesus could realize the purpose of His advent, Jesus was persecuted, and eventually Jesus had no choice but to walk the path of the cross. And we know through history the tremendous indemnity that had been paid for Jesus' crucifixion. God sent Jesus as His beloved Son for the first time in 4,000 years. Jesus came on earth to realize God's will. However, once again, due to the failure of humanity to realize God's will, a painful history had to begin again. And as He laid on the cross, Jesus prophesied that He would come again. And as He laid on the cross, There were two thieves to the right and the left of Jesus. The thief to the left of Jesus made fun of Jesus and criticized him. But the thief to the right said, "We are crucified because of our sins, but Jesus is innocent. He has no sin." And at that time, what did Jesus say? Jesus turned to the thief to his right and said, "You and I shall ascend to paradise tonight." One thing I would like to mention is that Jesus told the thief, "We will go to paradise." That is not the kingdom of heaven. Originally, God the Creator wanted human beings to achieve, to become fruitful, realize true ideal families, so that after their life on earth had ended, human beings who form true families would ascend to the eternal world, and that world is the kingdom of heaven in heaven. Jesus came by himself and ascended by himself without realizing a family, and that is why he prophesied that he would come again. And following Jesus' crucifixion through the Pentecost and the work of the Holy Spirit, the work of the apostles, Christianity expanded throughout the world. In the beginning, Christians were tremendously persecuted, but in 313 AD, Christianity was finally recognized and expanded throughout the Italian peninsula, to the European continent, to the British Isles, and through Britain expanded to the corners of the world. However, the missionaries who came in Jesus' name did not understand his essence, because Jesus teaches us, "Love your neighbor as yourself." But these missionaries went to the world. But rather than leaving for the sake of others, practicing true love and giving to all others, they became colonialists who took away from others. And this painful culture and history continued. In particular, the African continent has suffered tremendously and had to endure a painful history. God is love, and Jesus also always spoke about love, practicing love. However, colonialists who came with selfish intentions, plundering the colonies for the benefit of their respective nations, this is a fallen humanity. However, Jesus prophesied he would come again. That is why in the Christian cultural realm, the returning Lord must come to host the holy wedding of the Lamb. And that is why, what should Christianity look for? God the Creator, God created everything in pairs, a man and a woman. That is why 2,000 years ago, Jesus came as the only begotten Son, but there was no begotten daughter. And that is why in Christianity, the search for the only begotten daughter should have taken place. Through the people of Israel, the only begotten daughter could not come because Jesus had been crucified. And that is why heaven chose, raised another people. And in Asia, God chose the Han people, and in 1943, in a Christian cultural background, the only begotten daughter of God was born. The birth of the only begotten daughter is heaven's long cherished wish for the past 6,000 years. The purpose of heaven's creation is to realize an ideal world of happiness, and the work of the only begotten daughter is to realize this ideal. However, when I was born, Korea was under tremendous difficulties because although the Second World War had ended, Korea was divided once again into the Communist North and the Democratic South during the Korean War. At that time, my hometown was in North Korea, and many spiritual groups in Pyongyang believed that the returning Lord would not come in the clouds, but that the Messiah would be born in the flesh. These were spiritual groups. And as a result, centering on Pyongyang in North Korea, there was a strong belief that the returning Messiah would come in the flesh. And as a result, the citizens of Pyongyang remained in North Korea. However, in accordance with God's purpose of creation and principle of creation, heaven protected me so that I could grow and reach maturity. However, if I remained in a communist country, I could be the target of various attacks, and that is why I went to South Korea. And 2 years after I went to South Korea, the Korean War erupted, and South Korea by itself did not have the power to defend itself against North Korea's communist invasion. However, heaven miraculously mobilized the UN forces and protected democracy in South Korea. What do you think was the purpose of this miraculous providence? It was to protect the only begotten daughter born for the first time in 6,000 years, so that the only begotten daughter could grow, and with out of her own volition, she could uphold heaven's will. It was a period through which I could grow to maturity. And as a result, I knew heaven's will. Although I was still young, in 1960, I ascended to the position of true parents. true parents. Heavenly parents has waited for 6,000 years for the advent of true parents. In the Christian cultural realm, for 2,000 years, they've waited for the true parents. However, Christianity did not fully understand the providence. Rather than support the work of true parents, some Christians severely opposed us and persecuted us. And as a result, because true parents knew heaven's providence, true parents understood the wish of heaven, the love with which heaven wants to embrace all of humanity. True parents have worked their entire lives to guide humanity to God through the blessing, by bringing heaven's blessing to families worldwide. And next year it will be 60 years since this marriage blessing movement has taken place. Fallen human beings cannot return to God's bosom by themselves. Through true parents, fallen humanity can be born again by receiving the blessing. And this is the marriage blessing that I was mentioning before. Heaven has given us such a tremendous, miraculous love. The blessing is a gift of love from heaven. For 60 years, all over the world, the blessing movement has continued, and now, in 150 nations around the world, the true family values movement and the providence of true parents is expanding beyond religion, race, or nationality. Together with true mother, the only begotten daughter, an incredible providence is advancing. That is the only way to realize the dream of God, one family of humanity under God. And all the nations of the world can come together as one family under God, as brothers and sisters who live for the sake of one another, who love one another and live in peace and harmony. That path is the blessing movement. I'm sure that all of you have children, and as parents who love their children, you want to give boundless love to your beloved children. All parents want their children to prosper. And the heart of parents is incredible. No parent ever calculates how much love they have given their children. No parent ever says, I've given you 100 degrees of love, therefore you have to repay me 100 times. No parent says that. God's love, the love of true parents, is to give, 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 and forget you have given. It is true love, living for the sake of others and giving continuously. When all of humanity works together with true parents in unity to realize Heavenly Parents' dream by becoming filial children to our Heavenly Parent and walking the path of true children who form ideal true families, then the problems afflicting today's world can all be resolved. And God the Creator, His original ideal can be realized and the earth can be returned to the pristine condition in which God created this earth, and we can live a life of the kingdom of heaven on earth. Therefore, heaven's providence is eternal, and therefore as human beings we have the limit of the physical body. Therefore, let us raise our children in a true love so that heaven's will can continuously be realized and that our children can follow in our footsteps and contribute to the realization of God's will, one world of true love and peace, so that this world can become a model. And it is my hope that South Africa and Africa can be the model of the world. Right now, we may be thinking about our present, but we must not just think about our present. We must think about the past and look to the future, and let us liberate our ancestors through true parents' blessing. Furthermore, let us prepare a beautiful future by raising our children according to God's ways. Let us raise our teenagers. Let us guide them along God's ways so that we do not repeat the history of pain, and we can realize God's eternal ideal. We can realize the purpose for which God created human beings. Let us fulfill our mission, in particular, Your Excellencies, heads of states from wonderful nations. I invite you to stand in the position of leaders who can build a beautiful future for our descendants. I invite you to please promote the true family values, to promote the blessing in your nations, to promote healthy societies based on healthy families. By upholding the family, we will find a path to solving society's problems. I invite you, all distinguished leaders gathered here, to take up this responsibility so that we can realize this mission. Remember that God will always be with you. This is a blessed place. As it is written in the Bible, the first shall be last, and the last shall be first. When we look at Christian culture, Africa is always considered last. But from the point of view of God and true parents, Africa will be first, and you will be the blessed continent of Africa. Happiness, blessings, the more you share happiness and blessings, the greater the happiness and the blessings become. And this blessing will not just limit itself to Africa. Africa will be the blessing of the world and expand its blessings to the entire world. Heavenly parent, truly loves this continent, truly loves his beloved sons and daughters in the continent of Africa. God loves Africa. God is grateful for Africa. I hope that Africa can be a blessed continent.
Thank you. Thank you very much, true mother, for this wonderful and inspiring message. I would now like to invite for the flower presentation former Prime Minister Kwasi Kwarteng and his wife, representing all of us as a sign of appreciation and love towards true mother, Prime Minister Kwarteng and his wife. Under your applause, Prime Minister Kwarteng, representing all of us.